Well, it's very early in the season, but we have the top two involved today, and it could have a lot of significance down the road a ways. Stay with us. We'll have all the action for you here on EA TV, and it's live. Welcome to you, to the Hawthorns, the home of West Bromwich Albion Football Club. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith, former England international, of course, is in the commentary box with me as usual. And our action today comes from the Championship in England, West Bromwich Albion against Brentford.
Yeah, thanks, Martin. I think both teams here are going to be positive. They are set up to attack, so I'm expecting a few goals here today. I don't want to put the mockers on, but I am expecting a few.
Saw the goal and went for it. Well, goalkeepers like action. There was plenty of action for him there. Corner. Corner's taken. Punched away by the keeper. Break quickly when they get possession. Looks so promising at the beginning, but came to naught. And off he goes with some options. That was a penetrating pass, or would have been had it got past the interceptor. They have had some tremendous performances at home. In fact, Alan, it's the best home record in the league.
So hard to take points off this team at home. 9 wins in 10 games tells its own story, and not to fancy it.
Now the shot! No way through for the shot. Blocked. He's got possession back for his team. Bringing us up to date at Huddersfield now is Alan McAnally with a goal to tell us about, I believe.
It's a goal for Nottingham Forest. 12 minutes played, 1-0.
And we're back here again, thanks to Alan McAnally. With good vision. And in it goes towards the far post. Well read by the defender.
I love them shots.
If the silver hatchback with the license plate GR55JKK, please contact the nearest security guard. Thank you.
Nothing wrong with the industry of the team. That little bit of inspiration lacking, but they need to get their noses in front. Now, Albion can counter-attack. We're still going towards goal, quickly. And he gets it returned to him.
Golden opportunity now.
That's a good stop from the goalkeeper. Jensen. Play on, says the referee. Now they can swing into attack, and he's got some help. Cleared it well. A chance to whip it in here. Now the cross has gone behind. Poor effort. A reminder for you that on EA Sports we're covering the EFL Championship fixture, West Bromwich Albion. They'll be facing Barnsley.
Yeah, I've had a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well.
Well, he's read that, hasn't he, and made the interception, made it look easy, actually. Gives it away. Jensen. Well, here he goes. It's good to see a player do this. Gone out over the touchline. That'll be a throw to the opposition. Could be a cross here. It could be dangerous. Made sure the pass wasn't completed. Here's Robinson. Taking on a couple of opponents now.
Surely he must score!
Well, he tried to place it and could hardly have placed it further from the goal.
I can only think that got a horrible bobble. You know, that was a shocker.
Difficult for the defender against the player who wants to take him on like this. In the Fulham game, there's news of a goal. Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Leeds United. 35 minutes played. 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Corner played in. It's not really away. Poor clearance. Well, he hit it well enough.
Yeah, maybe just a bit off balance there, actually.
Jake Livermore. Wonderful work with the ball then. Nothing wrong with the in probing the pass. Gone a little early there, I think. Flags up.
Yeah, a bit over eager to get on the end of it.
He's cut it out. Sloppy work, really. Jansen. Let's go over to Alan McAnally with a goal to tell us about at the Kirklees Stadium.
It's a second goal for Nottingham Forest. 41 minutes played. 2-0.
That's Alan McAnally keeping us bang up to date. It's good work here in terms of possession. Can they find the final pass? Can go in from here. With his skill, here's a chance to have a run at goal and take the opposition on. West Brom quick on the break, and here they go. Couldn't hold on to the ball. The referee has chosen to add on two extra minutes. Gets the ball out wide with time to assess the situation. Aim for those in the middle. Could have done better with the cross into the goalkeeper's reach. And there is the half-time whistle. 0-0 at the break. Five minutes to go as we start the second half. Jansen. Here's Phillips. Jensen. And the ball's got away from him. This team really on top of their game, and they've got themselves to be top of the league by playing like this.
Yeah, they have. I mean, they've got some top play.
A great chance to go in front. Not really tested the goalkeeper, but sometimes it can look a bit too easy. He made sure he made the save competently.
Yeah, he did, and he doesn't make too many mistakes, this lad.
Look at those stats. Nothing really, either end. Quite unusual, that.
Great interception. Jensen. And that's broken up by the defender before the cross could come in. Throw in now. That's what the coach would want, to stop the supply into the middle. Tight scenario here on the ball. Made sure the pass wasn't completed. Referee's done extremely well to judge it like that. He can play the advantage. Able to intercept here. Substitute coming up for the away team. bringing us up to date at Huddersfield now is Alan McAnally with a goal to tell us about, I believe.
It's a third goal for Nottingham Forest. 65 minutes played, 3-0.
We're back here again, thanks to Alan McAnally. Jensen. Done well under pressure here to hold the ball as the challenge came in.
Certainly playing well enough to get their noses in front here.
Referee's done very well here. He let the game go on, but he knew there was a yellow card infringement in that move, and now he's gone back and shown the yellow.
Yeah, it was a definite booking. Player's got no complaints.
Fantastic save!
He's gone out for a throw. Now a chance to get a bit of width into this attack. No real challenge to the defender from that cross. Squeezed in against the touchline, it will be another throw-in. They've gone wide, chance to get the ball in the box. Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. Referee has blown, and he's given the free kick. I don't know whether the manager's told them to do this, but they're just defending deep and saying to the opposition, you can have the ball, you're not going to hurt us. Livermore, Filip Krovinovic. It's good attacking play, this, from them. Krovinovic, Jake Livermore. Is he in here? And the goalkeeper can take charge now. Got his foot in to cut out the pass. Substitution for West Bromwich Albion. That could open them up.
Not really tested to the full, the keeper that time.
Yeah, I think he saw it coming all the way, Martin.
But here comes the corner. Corner far too near the goalkeeper. He's at his best in those circumstances. Alan McAnally is our man at the Middlesbrough game today. And Alan, I believe you've got a goal to tell us about.
It's a goal for Stoke City. 79 minutes played, 1-0.
Eagle eyes, as always, from Alan McAnally. We've got 10 minutes left on the clock. And the ball with West Bromwich Albion again. Filip Krovinovic. Townsend. Jensen. Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. Whipped in from the wide area. Oh, goalkeeper, he cannot believe his luck, because that was a mistake by the goalkeeper. Chance for the cross. Towards the near post. Very straightforward piece of goalkeeping as he catches the cross. Read the intentions of the opposition there.
Everything
to make
the
interception
does is so bad. Like, it's actually, they haven't done anything good this year. We haven't touched the ball at all.
It is a team that
we get the
can
fucking ball.
Really
we're
hurt
team.
You with the
Why
number of passes that they play.
Home? We're top of the league and we're sitting back there.
Goes the board. Two added minutes.
Oh my god.
Oh, the move
pass,
and
man.
Able to
bad
cut out the
pass.
To really get at
it's
the opposition
disgusting.
Here.
I can't believe are they going to score? Please let them score.
In goes the cross.
We've been dominated.
That's a shame, because in the end, I would go down as a poor cross, really. It's finished level here at the final whistle. Well, you recognize him, I know, but he's definitely on view today. The top scorer in the league, and it's live.
Well, this is the setting for our featured match today. Welcome to you. Alan Smith has joined me, Martin Tyler, in the commentary position. And our action today comes from the Championship in England. It's Barnsley against West Bromwich Albion.
Yeah, real buzz around this ground. Full house. A lot of interest in it. Hope it doesn't disappoint.
Kieran Gibbs. Ooh, it's close, Alan. Offside is given.
He's quick enough. He doesn't need to do that.
And the lineup for the home side goes like this. Well, it's 4-4-2 for them today, but we think the middle four might be a diamond, Alan.
Yeah, and it gives them a bit of solidity in the middle of the park. And I think the onus is on the fullbacks to provide the width in this shape.
Bit of space to go forward into with the ball. Well, poor pass, good interception. Take your choice. The team now for you for West Bromwich Albion. Well, we think, Alan, it'll be a 4-5-1 formation, which can look a bit negative.
Yeah, but you look at the players in that five, that midfield five, and I think a couple at least will be trying to support the lone frontman.
Wonderful club, Fulham. But looking at the league table here, these aren't wonderful times for them. They've really found it hard since they lost their place in the Premier League. All sorts of managerial changes, changes of ownership.
Must take the lead here!
Well, they have cleared the danger. It was a decent opportunity, I think.
Sean, look how nice this would have been. Oh, look at this. I just used pure pace here. You know, I just knew I had the pace here to get past both of these. Look. Boom. Oh! I tried to dink it, but too late.
But he's kept the ball well. Well, a couple of star names that we're looking at today. What do you think, Alan?
Well, I think both of these players should come into this match.
Slipping it through.
Needs to stay cool now. And he's scored!
Well, it's the understanding you've got to admire here, Martin. The lad getting on to the end of it. The boy seeing the pass quickly.
Well, it's a goal worth replaying over and over again, isn't it? That has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. We need to bring you up to speed with the Hull City game. And Alan McInally's in a great position to do that. And news of a goal, Alan.
It's a goal for Nottingham Forest. 16 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Well, we'll follow that with interest. It looked a good cross, but in the end, it was misleading. Well, that'll be a throw. He's got the technique to deal with the press.
how they're looking to get forward from this position. This team really on top of their game, and they've got themselves to be top of the league by playing like this.
Yeah, they have. I mean, they've got some top players, haven't they? Let's face it, and they've shown that out there today. They've really played some good football.
Because maybe...
Well, let's hear about a goal at the KCOM Stadium, Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Hull City. 23 minutes played.
Lovely, incisive pass. He fancies his chances of getting past these players. Cross is blocked here. There's still danger here after this half clearance. They tried his luck, but his luck was out. I don't know whether the manager's told them to do this, but they're just defending deep and saying to the opposition, you can have the ball, you're not going to hurt us. Oh, great chance! He saved it, and saved it well. West Bromwich Albion have a corner now. In goes the corner. He's gone in with the header. But the ball nowhere near going into the net.
I think it's come off the top of his head, that one.
Played down the wing, keeping the wide attack going. This could bring them level. And it does! Important point in the game.
Well, what a game changer that might be. And I think the momentum's just shifted.
Good goal, yeah.
Well, I wonder whether the goalkeeper will blame himself for this, but it looked a good finish, even though he did get a touch.
Yeah, he's getting a few stares off his defenders. They thought he should have done better.
So, away we go at 1-1. Let's break away for a moment to go to Alan McAnally, who's got news of a goal in the game he's watching.
It's a second goal for Fulham. 32 minutes played, 2-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Good tackle. I think well stuck out a foot with good vision. Now it's offside, and it looks as though they might be in to score.
The visitors having lots of the ball, but they have been a bit disappointing so far in the way that they've gone about the business. I don't know if they've taken it a little bit easy. They were expecting to win this. I was expecting them to. Still got a good chance of doing that, but they've got to be better than so far.
Got some goal news for you from the Leeds United fixture, and it's Alan McAnally who can tell us all about it.
It's a goal for Leeds United. 38 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Read the play well to intercept. And here is Gibbs. That's good passing, probing. Left the defenders trailing now. Here's a chance. Oh, great work by the keeper. Well, here's a chance to get their noses in front from the corner. And he's dealt with it. That dangerous moment. Keeping the ball is one thing, but they've got to try and open up the opposition. They set it up well for the cross.
Why does that happen?
The referee's had a good look and decided what he's seen from this period of play to add on 3 minutes. Sloppy work, really. Going forward well. Got one possession back with that tackle. Interception here.
opportunity.
Still a chance in there off the goalkeeper. Well, everything to play for in the second half. We've reached half time at 1-1. Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start. Well, that is beautifully done.
Well, talk about individual skill, the ability to...
That was catching practice for the goalkeeper. He could take them on here. Must take the lead here, which they do in good style.
Yeah, they played some good football leading up to that, Martin, and thoroughly deserved that goal. He's left his man for Ted there. Such quick feet, and what a clinical finish.
And here is another angle on that goal.
Matos Pereira.
Off we go again, 2-1. Saw that coming and intercepted. At the KCOM Stadium for us today, Alan McAnally. News of a goal, Alan.
It's a third goal for Nottingham Forest. 52 minutes, please. 3-1.
Thank you very much, Alan.
Needs to say cool. Well taken goal and a good possession for them now. Now they're two in front. It's a great spell for this team. Two goals in rapid succession. Let's see the replay now. Three-one the scoreline as we restart the game.
Cream. Waters.
Diaby. This does look promising. He hasn't clipped it into the middle, he's driven it.
Well, there's a lot of talk about this lad, isn't it? And you can see why. It's such an important part of a team, the attacking side of it. But he does his other midfield jobs as well, but it's the attacking part of the game that's caught the eye today.
Yeah, that's a very important player in the modern game, somebody that can play a part defensively, but retains the energy and the ingenuity, really, to make a problem for himself going forward.
It's good work between these two. It's a good way to nick the ball back. Quick thinking. A reminder for you that on EA Sports, we're covering the EFL Championship fixture. Barnsley, they'll be facing Swansea City away from home.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Here's a chance.
Oh,
it's a tremendous goal. It's his third goal. It's a hat-trick today. He's really been on form.
How long have you been up for, Sean? How long have you been up for?
Well, maybe that's the one he'll treasure hours. The most, because it's given him the hat-trick.
Yeah, yeah. No, and he'll be taking home that match ball with a great deal of pride.
So I got a hat-trick. My second hat-trick for this time.
Well, from the neutral perspective, you do love to see attacking players playing as well as they can, and it keeps us on the edge of our seats, and he's certainly done that today. He's going to be taken off now.
Yeah, and he's got himself a few goals this season, and as a result, he's playing with a great deal of confidence, and that's vital for any striker.
What about West Brom's next match?
They're playing Middlesbrough in their next match in the Championship. Don't see them having too many problems.
Slipping it through. It was a promising situation. They could have made more of that. Should know better than doing this here. He's got to play it back to the goalkeeper. They want to just freshen things up a bit here, West Brom, I think, with a substitution. Into the attacking third. Good defensive play. No cross. And
I've
no
had
danger
five
now.
Five monsters.
Now, I think we've seen it. The visitors controlling possession. No wonder they're winning.
Sometimes you can have the ball and not be able to do anything with it, but this side have been quite the opposite. So creative and so clinical so far.
Here comes the challenge. Blocked it then. In goes the corner.
What's the mean say? Tell me.
William.
What?
Well, here he goes. I'm guessing a player do this.
Players
arriving in the middle now. That's an important clearance.
And that you're a jihadi ISIS member. What?
Now he's got the ball back.
Yes. It must be true.
Intercepted here.
What?
Throw in here.
Well, it's my interpretation, but I'm going to believe
this. Is interesting it's whether the manager is just going to switch things around a little bit.
What?
Away by
no
the
one else
defender.
Knows about this. It's you and me. It's not the song. Some 50 tenement
interpretation. Out in front of goal.
There I am. At the moment, I'm 50% of the interpretation. Yeah. And if I'm the first person, if I'm the first person to upload it and say give an opinion on it, it's going to be what everyone's opinion is.
Probing with the pass. Brave
what?
Blocking.
Hey,
Alan McNally is our man at the
K-Com
Stadium today. Alan, we're hearing there's been a goal.
It's another goal for Nottingham Forest. 79 minutes played. 4-1.
That's Alan McAnally keeping us bang up to date.
You never recognise her.
10 minutes left of regular time.
No, that's exactly what she said, though, isn't it? You don't recognise me. What? Is that not what she'd say? She said that. What would she say?
Now a chance to get a bit of width into this attack.
She would so say, you don't recognise me. What do you mean? You just came up with that look on the spot, you little f-
No, it
hasn't.
Yes, it has. Yes, it
has. Sure.
The team ready to make a change.
What? You can't use
that
anymore.
It's
a shit song, it's a
wish.
Yeah. It's a thing of nightmares. Every time you sing that, I think I'm going
to
die.
Steps up to take it. Oh,
what?
Because right
you did it for an infinite loop, made me sick of it.
Thanks,
this
Alan.
Is fucking the worst thing ever. No.
It's not a cross that's caused the defence any problems, and certainly not the goalkeeper. We're down now
what?
To the final 2 minutes
joking,
of the 90.
I'm serious, that's how horrible that
would
be. It's not even a joke, I'm serious, that's how horrible that would be.
He's cut that out well read.
Yes, I'm probably good.
To ooze around the crowd for a 3 minute add-on, which is what we're going to get for
no,
added time.
I can choose
an opportunity here. There's some space to work the ball into.
Not by doing that.
Successful tackle.
The natives are not happy with what they're seeing. Their team standing off the opposition, giving them far too much respect.
Schmidt stayed on his feet and won the ball. Final whistle.
There goes hat-trick. Ready? First I assist this, look how good this assist is. Just a very casual assist, look. Cool.
Slipping it through.
Perfectly timed that, wasn't it? And then I'll score this.
Must take the lead here. Which...
So nice, isn't it? First goal. Then, 3 minutes later. Yes, and then I scored this. Just waiting, made the run. Boom.
Here's a chance!
Hat trick. Three of the best. He's made them pay, and that completes a wonderful hat trick. Made them pay, didn't he? Trippy. Mm. What? It always looks like you're tripping. Scarlett Johansson, mate. Nope, he's way too tired to play any game. Time to do this thingy. Hopefully his composure and his reactions go up. And his acceleration. Composure, reactions, acceleration. Oh, 92 agility, that might be half after, might have to max out with that. Might have to max out at 92 agility. Might just have to. Come up. Yes, composure on up. Composure. What else gone up? Composure's so rare. I must say that composure rarely goes up. I must save it as a separate one. Save it as. Is this fine ones? Probably not the idea to take one hit now. I'm calling mum and dad in a few hours. Right, Sean? Probably not the idea to call him now. Call mum and dad now. No, I mean, take a hit now. Because calling mum and dad soon. At 2. No, it's 4 hours ago. 4. What? What? You got to make it. Oh, it's okay, well. Not gonna be happy. Every Sunday is Skype day. Oh, what time are you planning to sleep? What? Machina, no, Machina, time. You are a chromosome. Okay, I'm just gonna use this one, the composer's gone up, so.
Well, here he is, the top scorer in the league, the main feature of our match today, and it's live. Welcome to you, to the Hawthorns, the home of West Bromwich Albion Football Club. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith. On this special day, a very happy new year to you all. I hope we have a football match worthy of the occasion. West Bromwich Albion against Leeds United.
Yeah, happy new year, Martin. And for these two teams, it's about starting the new year as they mean to go on.
Pass threaded through. Almost got through, but the keeper picked it up in time. The team now for you for West Bromwich Albion. The system that we think they're going to go with is 4-5-1. That one striker will need a bit of support. He's one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Super reflexes from the goalkeeper. That's a very good clearance, and it was needed. Slipped past his marker. It's a real opportunity to get it into the middle. Trying to get the cross in, well blocked by the defender. Not really tested the goalkeeper, but sometimes it can look a bit too easy. He made sure he made the save competently.
Yeah, he did, and he doesn't make too many mistakes, this lad.
Well, the hosts come into this game with some very good statistics for their record here at home, and it is actually unparalleled in the league at the moment.
Well, 10 wins in 12 games, really. The manager could not have asked for any more.
West Bromwich Albion, they're playing well at the moment. They certainly played well last time out in their home victory against Middlesbrough.
Yeah, good solid 2-0 victory. They all played well, but might have to settle for a draw here.
Going for goal! Straightforward stop for Kiko Casilla. Livermore. It's Harrison.
Why am I left mid? I'm a right mid player. I don't know why they keep me on left.
It's Bamford. Tackle here at the Kirklees Stadium for us today, Alan McAnally, with news of a goal, Alan.
It's a goal for Stoke City. It's been scored by James McLean. A bit of a cheeky one. He let the ball go through his legs and flicked it home with his heel. 18 minutes played, 1-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Brilliant. Oh, the lead is here for the taking. Must be a goal. Well, here it is. The first goal of the game that they're absolutely dominated. Very good play. Defence opened up again, but the difference is this time that they put the ball past the goalkeeper. Good finish. And they're looking a very classy side at the moment. And that's a goal well worth analysing again.
My finishing's getting better.
Everyone, and that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Championship's too easy. I'm a Prem player. Andy's a Prem player now. Scoring this many.
Poor attempt at a pass, really. With his skill, here's a chance to have a run at goal. Must be a goal! Got to it somehow.
What a stop. That was heading right into the corner.
And in it goes. It's gone to the goalkeeper in very soft fashion. And the attacker cannot believe that he's messed this one up. Simple for the keeper.
Yeah, he can't believe his luck, can he, the keeper? Little Roy smile. He knows that that should have been a goal.
It's Harrison. Still searching for an equaliser. There's some good interplay here. Saw that coming and intercepted. Now he could play it into the danger area. Here's Casey. Now Helder Costa. Helder Costa. Spaced across the ball now. Neatly intercepted.
hosts can't quite get hold of the ball, but they won't mind that one bit because they've got their noses in front, and it's been a brilliant performance so far. I'm sure the manager on the sideline will be absolutely delighted.
Right.
Lost the ball. It's Harrison. Here's Casey. Referee has blown and he's given the free kick. That's an important clearance to Harrison. And that will be a goal kick. Here's Alan McAnally now to tell us about a goal in the Bristol City game. Alan.
It's a goal for Bristol City. 37 minutes played. 1-1.
Well, right on the spot there for that story. Alan McAnally, of course. Doesn't want to lose it here. Well, this could be dangerous in a wide position. Change of direction. Infield.
Chance.
It has hit the frame of the goal.
Alan, lucky there. He's got the placement inches away from scoring.
Pablo Hernandez. Now Helder Costa. White. Here's Casey. Won it back with an interception. It's good attacking play, this, from them. Austin. 2 more minutes to play of added time.
2 minutes of added time.
He has cleared it well. Jake Livermore. That is a tackle and a half. Well, the referee has signalled for half-time.
Sean comes flying at the speed of sound to tell him where it all began.
Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start. And they're looking good when they get the ball out wide, as they've done here. It's good work here in terms of possession. Can they find the final pass? And he gets it back. A bit too hard trying to force the pass, and it went straight to an opponent. Excellent interception. Comes in strongly. That's great defending there, stopping that attack. Very confident, even in his own defensive third, to keep the ball. That's something for him to chase. What an important goal this may well be. Two ahead now, building a platform for victory. He took it with great aplomb. I'm sure getting the first goal gave him the confidence to grab the second chance here. Restarting at 2-0. Craven Cottage is our man today, Alan McAnally. He's got a goal to tell us about.
It's a goal for Fulham. 54 minutes played. 1-1.
Thanks, Alan.
Leeds ahead in the possession stats. You can see the manager down there is
guided through. Oh, it's an offside decision.
Well, the players can't believe it, and neither can the crowd, but it's the right decision.
Action on the benches. Both teams are going to make a substitution. Being closed down. What we've got on EA Sports very soon for you, our presentation of the FA Cup fixture. West Bromwich Albion, they'll be facing Blackburn Rovers.
Yeah, really looking forward to this one. I think we're going to see some good football.
What about Leeds' next game?
They're playing Bournemouth in their next match in the FA Cup, and not much at all to split the two sides for me.
They've got the ball back by that interception. And it's been an hour of very good football here. We've still got 30 more minutes to go, and I'm sure we're going to enjoy that as well. Read the play well. Jean-Kevin Augustin. And the tackle there is successfully done. Some goal news with good vision. With his skill, here's a chance to have a run at goal and take the opposition on. And this is going to be a throw. Substitute coming on. It's a tactical change. Oh, McAnally there with a very brief report, a bit briefer than he wanted, I think. Confirming for you the Brentford goal in that match.
Has to score!
He looked to be maybe too precise, Alan.
Yeah, I think so. Instead of just getting some power behind it, tried to be a bit too clever from close in.
Here's Harper.
Oh, Harper's playing this game.
Lovely, incisive pass. Had to be brave coming out there, the goalkeeper.
And Harper linking up. Harper, me and Sangre.
Luke Ayling.
Sangare.
Let's go to Craven Cottage now and hear about a goal from Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Reading. 70 minutes played, 2-1.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. Adam Forshaw. Helder Costa. Luke Ayling. Now Helder Costa. Pablo Hernandez. Players up in support if he needs them. Nothing wrong with that tackle. In fact, it was a terrific effort. I want to just freshen things up a bit here, West Brom, I think, with a substitution. Filip Kravinovic.
Really in the clear now, in on goal.
Clean through, one-on-one against the goalkeeper.
Yeah, it's a wonderful stop, Martin, isn't it? And no bits and pieces either to follow up on.
Today, Alan McAnally is at Huddersfield Town. Alan, news of a goal in that Huddersfield game.
It's another goal for Stoke City. 76 minutes played, 4-0.
Thanks, Alan. Out of play for a throw. Rosicki could whip it in from here. Tried to wallop it in from close range, and they're still trying to get the ball back.
Well, it may have taken a bubble, Martin. Let's be generous there.
Luke Ayling. Pablo Hernandez. Now the countdown is to 10 minutes left. Filip Kravinovic. Trying to find the opening, which would be so crucial. Good interception. Barry Douglas. It's Harrison. That's another turnover here. Augustin. Douglas. It's Harrison. And the pass not completed, really. They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this attack. Great chance!
No. It's come off the goal. So look how nice this goal would have been. Well, she fucked it again. Sean. How nice this goal would have been. It's a nice pass, right? I'm really low on stamina here, so like you can tell he's tired. This turn's so nice. Imagine if I just slotted that. Oh, it would have been so nice.
Beautiful goal.
Well, that really is rubbing salt into the wounds. It's been a one-horse race out there today. Oh, I always used to love scoring these type of goals. When you're there first, it feels good, this.
Well, the game petering out a little bit now, with both sides settling for what's on the scoreline. Vast difference between the two teams. And the verdict on added time is 2 minutes to Harrison.
Jean-Kevin Augustin, West Bromwich Albion, have gone and got the possession back.
Has
and that was in the mid 80s.
It's one on one with the goalkeeper. Brilliant play. Oh, the lead is here for the taking. Must be a goal. With his skill, here's a chance to have a run at goal. Must be a goal. Change of direction, infield. That's something for him to chase. Has to be! Has to score! He looked to be... Limprovinovic. Really in the clear now, in on goal. Clean through. One-on-one against the goalkeeper.
Yeah, it's a wonderful stop, Martin, isn't it?
Rosicki. Now, here is a chance for them. Great chance! That's come off the goalkeeper.
Dreading your teammate. I can tell how you're dreading it so much. So many. You need a tea break.
What a perfect day for football we've got here. I'm Martin Tyler, with me is Alan Smith. Our football is from the EFL Championship in England. Charlton Athletic against West Bromwich Albion.
Well, what an arena we've got here. Perfectly suited to football and two very noisy sets of fans. What a backdrop that should be to what on paper should be an entertaining match.
Now a check on Charlton Athletic. 4-4-2, but a diamond shape is how he's gone, particularly during matches. It may be that he's going to start with a diamond today.
Yeah. I've seen his
chance now to go
oh
ahead.
My god. Oh my god, oh my god. Look at what my teammate just scored. Sean, like, I wasn't involved in this at all, but look at this goal. The passing shot, look at this. I'm not involved in this at all. Well, he takes the ball then, look at this pass. Oh, that's crazy.
Well, they've gone for it right from the off, and they've got their reward with an early opening goal here.
And he's just put his foot through this, Martin, and it's flown into the top of the net.
And we can see a slightly different viewpoint on it. So the first goal, it's 1-0.
West Bromwich Albion goal, number 47, Callum Robinson.
And they've got a man out wide. Little piece of interplay between the two. I think the wide man's got a chance here. There's space out near the touchline. He can cut it back now. Never panicked. Placed it past the goalkeeper.
Wow.
That's a very fine goal for West Bromwich Albion.
Well, he could hardly miss that. From the right wing, that was a perfect delivery.
And they got their reward for it. Another angle on it here.
Beautiful.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
West Bromwich Albion, number 10, Matt Phillips.
One of their better passes, and he's given it away here. Now they can go forward, having won the ball. At the KCOM Stadium for us today, Alan McAnally. News of a goal, Alan.
It's a goal for Fulham. 14 minutes played, 1-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Saw the pass coming and got there first. Has done well here until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right idea, but couldn't find his man. It's out over the touchline. Untidy work. Saw the pass and dealt with it. Now a chance to get a bit of width into this attack. Cullen. Field. David Davis. Going forward with real purpose now. Defensive block there. No cross coming in.
I love those toy, like, car-like. It was like a thing.
Jake Livermore.
Toy, car-like. Garage, not garage,
here's
like
Robinson.
There's like lifts and stuff. I remember an ad for it in my head just now.
Good try with that back heel.
I remember really running it and really watching stuff about cars and stuff. Like,
now he wants to take them on. That's a shot well off the mark. Watching the Reading game for us today is Alan McAnally, and he's got a goal to tell us about. Alan.
It's a second goal for Nottingham Forest. 28 minutes played, 2-0.
Thanks, Alan. It's a bit lazy in possession. a good goal. They pulled one back now, and they're only one behind now. And there's still plenty of life in this match as they look to level it up. Off we go again, 2-1. Here's Robinson, made the challenge well. Here's Williams. And the ball with West Bromwich Albion again. It's good attacking play, this, from them. Here's Davis. And it's Williams. Field. Referee doing everything possible to keep this game flowing.
That's an easy cutout for the opposition, saw the pass coming.
The game being played in one half of the pitch at the moment. The team with possession finding it hard, though, to get into areas where they're going to score a goal.
Another turnover in play here with that interception.
Goal news coming in for you from the Reading game, and it's from Alan McAnally. Can tell us all about it, Alan.
It's a third goal for Nottingham Forest. 41 minutes played, 3-0.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. Here's Davis. Good work, really, to read the intention of the pass. Great touch on the ball.
The referee has indicated
Robinson.
There will be a minimum of 2 minutes of added time.
Great interception. A chance to whip it in here. Now it's offside, and it looks as though they might be in to score. The booking is going to happen here. It's a yellow card. He's gone back to the offender.
Always like to see that, to give the advantage to the attacking team.
Well, this is half-time. That's the whistle. Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start. Excellent play. He's won it back easily. He's overhit the pass. It's a shame, good idea. At the KCOM Stadium for us today, Alan McAnally. News of a goal, Alan.
It's a second goal for Fulham. 50 minutes, please. 2-0.
Well, right on the spot there for that story, Alan McAnally, of course. Well, they've got the opposition on the back foot with this break. In with a chance. Oh, what a fine goal. They lead by two now. They'll feel a little bit more comfortable. And good value for this advantage at the moment.
Well, he was on his toes. The defenders were on the heels. Good take.
A good look here again by the replay of the goal. Just a reminder, 3-1 it is now, the scorer. Substitution for West Bromwich Albion. Good passing, probing. Intercepted well. I think the wide man's got a chance here. There's space out near the touchline. And then he went, just diverted it away. Let's go over to Alan McAnally, because there's been a goal in the Reading game. Alan can bring us right up to date.
It's another goal for Nottingham Forest. 56 minutes played, 4-0.
That's Alan McAnally keeping us bang up to date.
The visitors having lots of the ball, and we've been treated to some really good football, because with that possession, they've created a lot of chances and made life awfully difficult for the opposition. Deserved leader so far.
to Davis. Trying so hard to make the opening there. Nearly.
What about West Brom's next match?
Yeah, they're playing Stoke City in the next match in the Championship. And I don't know really what the score's going to be here. I don't think there's going to be much between them.
He could take them on here. That's good defending. He really had to deal with that. Could have really hurt the team now. Well, the assistant has flagged straight away for the offside.
Well, he's a quick runner, this boy, and if he just delays it for a second, you'd still get in.
Action on the benches. Both teams are going to make a substitution. Watching the Reading game for us today is Alan McAnally, and he's got a goal to tell us about. Alan.
It's a goal for Reading. 66 minutes played. 4-1.
Top work, Alan. We're back here now with Alan Smith. They can get one back now. Good work from the keeper. Corner swung in. Keeper goes for a punch. Time to get the ball in. And he can take possession in his own half. They have spent the big bucks, Barcelona.
And he is a good player. He's got plenty of excellent years ahead of him in my book. So that £65 million, that ballpark figure.
Looking for a through ball. Well, it's come to nothing in the end. David Davis. Here they are, still probing away. They want to just freshen things up a bit here, West Brom, I think, with a substitution. We can hear about a goal in the Stoke City game. Alan McAnally will tell us all about it.
It's a goal for Millwall.
Good vision. Needs to stay cool now. And there it is!
I'm sure the manager will be delighted with this. Fantastic teamwork. Lovely ball through.
Well, the body language at this kickoff isn't great, is it? And you can understand why. Alan McAnally there with a very brief report, a bit briefer than he wanted, I think. It was Millwall who scored in that game, and they now lead by that goal, 1-0. The home team about to make a change. It's good work between these two. Alan McAnally is our man at the Stoke City game today, and he's got a goal to update us about. Alan, over to you.
It's a goal for Stoke City. 78 minutes played. 1-1.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. Really good chance, no one on him. They have got a goal, and we should give them a pat on the back for that, because some teams would have packed it in at this stage. Plenty of goals for the fans here. 4-2. Off we go again. The scorer will be very proud of this, but it won't mean too much in terms of the result, just a personal triumph for him.
Yeah, I think so. The opposition really had stopped playing because they know that they've won the game.
They're looking to make the change now as quickly as possible, the home team. Krovinovic. Set up to play on the break now. Encouraging play from this team now. Keeping the ball. He's in here! That was a puff out your cheeks moment, and phew, got away with it. A switch here for them. In fact, it's going to be a double switch. Two substitutes coming on. So easy in possession. Real opening now. He's had a real go. It's a decent effort, that, with plenty of sting in it.
Yeah, not far away. He really did fizz it, didn't he?
Four more minutes. Filip Krovinovic. Played back. Furlong. Saw the direction of the pass. Krovinovic.
The fourth official has indicated there will be a minimum of 2 minutes of added time.
to Davis. A little too eager to get in behind the opposition, caught offside. But we're down to the last minute here. And there's the last blast on the... on the back foot with this break. They're coming in with a chance. Good vision. Needs to stay cool.
John, why is it just like at that temperature? It's not hot or cold. It's just like dead. Just uncomfortably normal. Season, my guy has.
Yeah, my dreams were realized. The wings was double fried. My was stuck between the peas and kettle fries. I quit with the beef, then I gave up the poke. Then I snatched up a cosign from one of the goats. Come on in, you let.
Tell her how much I love her for fucking armed with the water. Doesn't seem like being older than my uncle. Some people call it good or I call it another level.
Well, tension in the air here. It's got all the ingredients, hasn't it? And it's our main feature today on EA TV. Join us soon. Welcome to you to the Hawthorns, the home of West Bromwich Albion Football Club. Martin Tyler along with Alan Smith with you to provide the call today. Our football is from the EFL Championship in England. West Bromwich Albion against Stoke City.
Yeah, real buzz around this ground. Full house. A lot of interest in it. Hope it doesn't disappoint.
Can he take the ball in this area and keep them going up the field? The team now for you for West Bromwich Albion. Sam Johnson's the goalkeeper. Matty Phillips starts. He was man of the match last time out. And just one up front for them today. The Stoke City team, here it is for you. James Chester plays with Ryan Shawcross in central defence. Thomas Ince starts alongside James McLean in midfield. Sam Vokes is the lone striker today. In powerfully there. Room in which to attack. Good support running on either side. It is a success for the host today, based so far on shutting out the opposition.
Well, defending is an art, and sometimes a forgotten one in this day and age, but this lot haven't forgotten it, that's for sure.
Livermore. Opportunity here. There's some space to work the ball into. Not the way to try and get the ball.
Yeah, it's the kind of tackle that just isn't allowed these days.
To take the lead. There it is. First goal of the game. And coming this early. The promise of more to come.
Fuck you, Stoke.
That's a very fine goal for West Bromwich Albion.
The defenders seem to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming from a long way out.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
a good ball. Switch the play with it. Patiently building up. Sharp in the tackle. It'll be a throw now. Can whip it in now. Well, here he goes. It's good to see a player do this. And he's got his block in and the cross doesn't get into the middle. Well, it's cleared, but it's gone behind. It's a corner. Corner played into the middle. Only partially cleared, so there's still some problems for them. At Craven Cottage is our man today, Alan McInally. He's got a goal to tell us about.
It's a goal for Middlesbrough. 70 minutes played, 1-1.
Thanks, Alan. Well, we'll follow that with interest. Jake Livermore. Robinson. It's good play, this. The opposition can't get at them when they're keeping the ball. Ince is Allen. Well defended, not just getting across. He thought quickly as well. Did well, stuck out a foot, cut off the pass. James McLean. Stopping the pass getting through with a good piece of anticipation. Great change of direction. Brilliant ballon. Badly timed tackle. He'll be booked for that. Easy decision for this referee. There's going to be no leniency here. It's got to be a card, a yellow one.
Yeah, he reached for that back pocket straight away. And out it came.
It goes out wide again. Well, he tried to get the ball wide. It's been cut out. And it's Thompson. And now Thompson saw the pass and dealt with it. Well, let's hear from Alan McInally, who's covering the Nottingham Forest game for us today. And I believe it has a goal to bring us up to speed with. Alan.
It's a goal for the visitors. 29 minutes played. 1-1.
Well, many thanks, Alan McInally, keeping us up to date as usual. Ince still searching for an equaliser. There's some good interplay here. Livermore. Plenty of space out wide and they're going to use it. Referee's not going to like that one.
It's definitely a yellow in the mind of the referee, definitely.
Well, I think it questionably was. I mean, on another day, he might have been a red for that. It was a really dangerous challenge. This lad tends to put a bit of whip on these free kicks. Needs it here.
Saved by the goalkeeper, that free kick. Townsend. Thompson.
Folks.
That's good passing, probing. Oh, great ball. Well, it's come to nothing in the end. Stoke City go and win it back again. Ball glued to his boots, it seems. Excellent
that?
Work. Allen. He's cut it out. It's good attacking play, this, from them. Oh, great chance. And the goalkeeper got a touch to that. Fine save. Swung in. It's not really away. Poor clearance. Got in the way.
Shawcross. Oh.
What? Chooses to punch here, the goalkeeper. Good technique. Stokes corner. In goes the corner. Cleared away by the defender. Well, the referee has signalled for half time.
I'm going to set the nose in the penis.
Whistle from the referee. And we're off and running again for the second half. Here's Thompson. Folks. James McLean. Interception here. An update for you and a goal update for you from Queen's Park Rangers and their game. Here's Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Leeds United. 46 minutes played. 2-0.
Great to have Alan McAnally out and about for us. And he's brought us right up to date again there. And they've got it away from the danger. Now he can cross it. The target. Players in the centre. Proper defending under some pressure. Just take a note of this EA Sports coverage of the EFL Championship fixture.
West Bromwich Albion, they'll be facing Cardiff City away from home.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Ince, Sam Vokes, got a one possession back with that tackle. Today, Alan McAnally is at Huddersfield Town. Alan, news of a goal in that Huddersfield game.
It's a second goal for Brentford. 54 minutes played, 2-0.
Well, right on the spot there for that story, Alan McAnally, of course.
On to Stoke City's next game, Alan. Any thoughts?
Well, they're playing Swansea City in the next match in the Championship. And judging by the way that they've been playing, they're really evenly matched.
James McLean. James Chester. Quick-witted and quick in his movement too to intercept there. And this news will make some headlines. Harry Kane has moved to Real Madrid.
Yeah, well, you pay peanuts, you get monkeys, as they say, but they haven't done that. £130 million for a top-class player.
The build-up is patient. Can whip it in now. In a great position to pull it back. Trying to... Oh, chance! Turned aside there by the keeper.
So we'll restart with a throw.
He's got a chance to cross. Jake Livermore. Guiding it through. He's in on goal. Brilliant goal!
Oh, the crowd appreciating that. And so are his teammates. What a good finish and what a good ball through to him.
And that's a goal well worth analysing again. Starting at 2-0.
We've had a pair of car keys handed in at reception. A pair of car keys and a wallet. If those are your items, please collect them after the game. Thank you.
Substitution for West Bromwich Albion. Livermore. Filip Pravinovic. Pravinovic.
The hosts have controlled possession here so far. No wonder they're winning. Sometimes you can have the ball and not be able to do anything with it, but this side have been quite the opposite. So creative and so clinical so far.
And they've got it away from the danger.
Well, it's
one change, and it looks like it's a case of just trying to freshen the team up a bit.
To be replaced by number 19, Romain Saïs.
Furlong. He fancies his chances of getting past these players. Good tackle. Attacking now. Intercepted here. Well, he wants to run at them with the ball. It's good to see. He's a defender on top of his game here, and certainly on top of the opposition then. He will be furious with himself for such a poor pass. Able to intercept here. They are the league leaders, Alan, and they're playing like league leaders.
Yeah, they are. They've got a swagger about them, haven't they, Martin? Produced some majestic stuff today.
Well, they talk about football being a passing game, and you can keep it short, you can go long, you can be direct, you can keep possession, but they seem to have got all the passing arts here.
And they really force the opposition to chase the ball, and they'll be hoping that that means they tire out towards the end of this game.
Needs to say cool. The safe hands from the goalkeeper there, not the most demanding save, but it had to be made.
Yeah, easy though to take it a little easy, take your eye off the ball.
Wonderful chance. Up for grabs here. They should win now, shouldn't they? 2-0 here, not much time to go. What impact will that have on the next game?
Well, yeah, well, West Bromwich Albion go up against Cardiff City after this. And they have played well, they've stroked the ball around, and they'll be hoping to continue that.
On the attack here. Well, stuck out a foot and cut off the pass. Two minutes of added time. That's what it says on the board. Just 1 minute left on the clock. He's given it away. Final whistle.
Cutlery, stay frozen.
Welcome to you to the Hawthorns, the home of West Bromwich Albion Football Club. Alan Smith, the former England international, is alongside me, Martin Tyler. Our football today comes from the FA Cup. West Bromwich Albion, and they take on Southampton.
Yeah, a long way to go in this competition to get to the final, but good form here has a knock-on effect to a club's league campaign. And that's what the managers will be most concerned about, I think.
Chance, can't hang onto it, the keeper. Well, he really could be the star of the show today.
What about this player? 4 in his last 3 games. Watch out today.
What?
What? Ings.
You found a sock.
Well, that'll be a throw.
Where? Where is that?
Edwards. An opportunity here. There's some space to work the ball into.
Probably not a used sock if it was in there. Right?
Steered through. Good
listen,
clearance.
It's probably. You know how like. Yes, probably because he's in there.
I think the cross is on.
Probably was washed with the sheet and then fucking ended up taken out. Yeah.
Well, that was out of... Can put them in front here. Well, it was a bit desperate, but what a good challenge. Being closed down. Cut it out. Edwards. Patient play from them. Still trying to get his shot off. Pick his spot now. And we've got a goal. That's the first one. And I think there'll be a few more to come.
This is the only pass I could have done to get this assist.
Excellent for his team.
Side, right?
Easy for him.
Well, he's laughing and joking about it because it was perhaps the easiest goal he's ever scored in his career.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. Intercepted well. Edwards. Good vision here. Across dealt with by the defender.
This is a message for away supporters. At full time, can you please remain where you are?
Real chance! What an important goal this may well be. They're 2 ahead now, building a platform for victory. That's a very fine goal for West Bromwich Albion.
Well, it's come in from a long way out, and from that angle, it's not always easy to finish.
Defenders caught out by it in the end. Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
Right now, in Tokyo, Pachinko. It's just completely loud. Fine. unable to play properly.
Deflected out for a throw.
The UFO catches.
Only partially cleared, so there's still some problems for them.
The hosts have controlled possession here so far, and we've been treated to some really good football, because with that possession, they've created a lot of chances and made life awfully difficult for the opposition. Deserved leaders so far.
That's the last line of defence, but how strong he was. Did look a dangerous attack until the interception. Here's Edwards. Set up to play on the break now. They could be in behind the back line. And it's going to be his throw here. Now the possibility for a cross. Got the ball, and they're going at the opposition with speed. Well, the ball's been deflected out, so it'll be a throw-in. Looking to attack it in the middle. That was a good crossing position, but not a good cross. Armstrong. It's Ings. Shot blocked here. Throw-in now. Ings. Bit of space to go forward into with the ball. I think the cross is on. Tackled well. Test of his control now. Another turnover here. Here's Danny Ings. Armstrong. It's Ings trying to spot a potential ball to open them up, but they're keeping the ball well. Closed him down well. The cross doesn't come in. Good defending. Furlong. Well, they're getting the ball forward. They need to do that. Excellent challenge from the defender in his own penalty area. 2 minutes left. That's added time. Armstrong.
She doesn't love me.
Going forward well. Well, that's a great block. Swung in from the corner. Good stop by the goalkeeper. And the referee is blown for half time. It's 2-0 here. Players have had their chance to assess what the first half brought for them. The start now of the second half of this game in the Emirates FA Cup.
Yeah, interesting to know what the two managers would have said in those half-time dressing rooms, but I'm expecting a really good clash here.
And in he goes with the tackle. And it's gone out of play there.
And they're doing basically an animation, so obviously it's going to work.
Edwards. Livermore. Here's Edwards. Jake Livermore. No great danger here, but they've got the ball. That's the most important thing.
This might be it! What a goal! And what a build-up that was, the way that they pulled the opposition out of position, so patient until they did have an opening. What a marvellous goal.
They always say this team, they want to pass the ball at pace with a tempo to it.
Oh, son, look at that again. I didn't see exactly what he did though. Look at this in the middle of the box. It's against Southampton as well in the FA Cup. So the first biggest game probably I've had. Just does this, boom, rolls it, and then does a boom. Step over, roll, step over. Look, roll, step over, boom, boom. Oh, that's disgusting.
And they've done it just here and got their reward.
Yeah, I mean, the passing sequence is great, but if there's no finish on the end of it, it comes to nothing, but the lad really did tuck that away well.
I don't think we expected this. Such a one-sided affair, but look at the scoreline.
See stats for the season, but whoa, he's doing amazing. He's doing this kind of penalty club.
Well, they've got the opposition on the back foot with this break. They're coming at them with numbers. It'll be a throw.
Upper half penalty.
Well, they put the bye into Bayern again with this transfer deal.
Well, there's been an awful lot of talk, and why not? It's about £80 million they've spent on this player.
That is a good punch by the goalkeeper. Closing him down. Well, he's got a chance now to get forward in this wide area. They set it up well for the cross. Well, he used the inside of his head well, but not the outside, off target.
Yeah, just slightly missed time, that one.
Oriol Romeu. Armstrong. Here's Danny Ings. And it's going to be his throw here. Well, this fullback has covered every blade of grass on either side of the pitch. He's not going to quite go the distance here. But what an energetic performance, Iker. It's a good hit. Just throwing his body into the way of the shot. Chance for West Brom to show their speed and counter-attack. Oh, he's through. Well, that's straightforward for the goalkeeper. Krovinovic steered through. Well, he's hit it hard, too hard maybe.
Yeah, I don't think he's playing with as much confidence as he would like at the moment.
Filip Krovinovic, Jake Livermore. Well, they could get the ball back here and they have done.
I'm not serious. Fancy English people going.
Oriol Romeu.
Telling Japanese people, why is that?
Ings. Here's Danny Ings. And 20 minutes to go. Krovinovic. Yeah, he's got the ball back. Oriol Romeu. Adams. Very well done to switch the play. Tackled well.
I'm not talking about specifics.
Out to a wide man who's got room. Tries to shot here. And turned away by the goalkeeper spectacularly. And that's gone for a corner for West Brom. Corner swung in. Put away, but not out of harm's way. Livermore! Needed to be brave, and he was. And that will end the threat, at least for the moment. Good tackle. Oriol Romeu. Adams. Reading of the play, anticipating the pass. Now the countdown is to 10 minutes left. Gonna try it. It's a really good opportunity. A player of his ability would bury that.
Why he missed that? No way he missed that. I need to watch that. How the fuck did he miss that?
Nine times out of ten.
He's going to find it difficult forgetting about that one for the next few days.
Townsend. Terrific play on the ball.
Oh, lovely clean feet and
excellent vision. Top performance from a top team, and they've emphasised their superiority with the number of goals that they've scored.
Everybody wants to get in on the act. The strikers can improve their goal ratios. It's a free-for-all out there.
It is now an extraordinary lead, and you could say really game over. Adam.
Oriol Romeu.
And off he goes with some options. That's a good way to see it out here. If you can hang on to the ball and really frustrates the opposition, don't blame them for doing it.
It's in the laws, the advantage, and the referee applying it well then. And that's going to be a free kick.
Filip Krovinovic. Teammates getting out of the way because they know he can dribble it here.
We've got two added minutes. That's been signaled now.
2 minutes of added time.
Livermore. Harper. This does look promising. Oh, saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch. Grasped in the end by the goalkeeper finally, after a frantic piece of play, which included a remarkable save just a moment or strong performance here. Still trying to get his shot off. Pick his spot there. Real chance. What an impact. This might be it. What a goal.
And what a build-up that was. The way that they pulled the opposition out of position, so patient until they did have an opening. What a marvellous goal.
Krovinovic steered through. Well, he's headed out to a wide man who's got room. Tries to chop here. He's gonna try it. It's a really good opportunity. Excellent vision. Top performance. This does look promising. Oh, so.
All my stats this season are, Sean. Twenty-six goals and 16 assists in 24 games. I am the GOAT. Money with the world, do backflips. Make sure you keep it all together. Elastic, stretch it. Make sure the money do. This one must have came from. If I say, then it's gonna be a lot thing. What do you mean, man? I sound like this guy, which guy? I don't even know what he. Let me sip my tea. Can't take me for a month. Man, I've done it sometime. What time are you gonna go bed? Matters. Nelson. You mean you don't know Shaw? What? A little Pinani, no. Nothing I like went up there, so I'm gonna have to go again. My name is the welfare, I'm gonna go again. She said it's about the future, and would you believe her if she said she said it's about the future, and would you believe her if she said it's about the future? Stretch it, must have thought that we came up from nothing. Back then, we didn't have Sky Sports. What game, like I didn't even watch it. OT, OT, always get love when we go OT. But bro, G, me, keep stacking up racks. Weighing up, shh, now you don't go sleep. Aye. Are you taking a Netflix, mommy shooting clips? Got my guy doing overtime on a Sunday night, he was taking risks. Phone bros, don't pull up outside, that's nothing but bad. Treat my guys like siblings. Hop in the car like a GTA. My bro touch NJ back came with a big stack like yo is a madness. See the money under the mattress, even the cool when your name they stressing, they stress it. I don't even know them man there. This one must came from. If I say then it's gonna be a mad thing. Stretch it, make sure the money do. Stretch it, make sure the money do. Stretch it, make sure the money do. Stretch it, stretch it, stretch it. I'm going to give you a haircut, Sean. I reckon I can get fade properly now. You sure? Zilla takes a death like a boat. I've been here since the opening of the gate. Call me the realist, but I'm just the pillist. A pilgrim I live in base. Ecambelis is a phyllis. Such a cool question that is asking me a pillist. It's a epiphany pillis. This if I can even realize pillis. It's a pillis. Telescope. Tell us more stories that give us hope. I'm not a rapper, but I know that's true. You're a Macintosh, a Macintosh, back in time, cause that is posh. Mortal, I'm the snorkel's fine. It's not broken, I'm tasting salt water, and my lungs is not tasting good. It is a fantasy. You are a fantasy. Nani. Plus one acceleration, plus one sprint speed, plus two reactions, plus one composure.
What? What?
It has to be this one. There's no other choice, it has to be this one. You got really small hands. Trump. Trumpino. What? You know what you are? POTUS. POTUS. POTUS Bramble.
Can he add to the goals he scored already this season? He's already the top scorer in the league. What a match. And it's live. Welcome to you to the Hawthorns, like the home of West Bromwich Albion Football Club. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith sitting alongside me. Our football is from the EFL Championship in England. West Bromwich Albion against Luton Town.
I think if we get a nice, sharp, quick tempo to begin with, we're in for a real treat here because we've got a couple of
looking for a through ball. And he bangs it away. The team now for you for West Bromwich Albion. Sam Johnston's the goalkeeper. Matty Phillips starts, a midfielder in good form. And they just go with the one striker up front. Chop back and play it to a teammate. And as for the opposition, this is their starting 11. Well, it's the old joke, isn't it, Alan? Diamonds aren't forever, but they are. Well, that's absolutely miles offside. Wonderful club, Fulham. But looking at the league table here, these aren't wonderful times for them. They've really found it hard since they lost their place in the Premier League. All sorts of managerial changes, changes of ownership as well. And it's rather reflecting on the field, and certainly reflected in this look at the league standings.
Well, I had them down as title challengers. I can't believe where they are at this stage in the season. And I just don't think they're going to recover now.
Yeah,
really anticipating something special from...
What is that?
Him here today.
Four goals in his last three games. Really does look a class act at the moment.
What is it?
The assistant has raised the flag for offside. An incisive pass. Neatly intercepted. Livermore. We need to bring you up to speed with the whole City game. And Alan McInally's in a... That's something for him to chase. All peters out, rather, for them. Cross is blocked here. Gets in the way of it, the defender. Well, sorry that Alan McInally couldn't finish his update there. Confirmation for you of the Brentford goal in that game. And they now lead by that goal, 1-0. Collins. Now Brown. Yates. The goal that would put them in front doesn't look too far away the way they're playing. Livermore. Robinson. Catch-up time with Alan McInally, who's at the Birmingham City game, and news of a goal, Alan.
It's a goal for Nottingham Forest. 20 minutes played, 1-0.
Great to have Alan McInally out and about for us, and he's brought us right up to date again there. Trying to get the cross in, nearest defender blocked it. Able to intercept here. Potts.
Pearson. There's the interception. Here's Collins. Now Brown. Let's check in with Alan McAnally, who's at Fulham. And there's news of a goal, Alan.
It's a goal for Fulham. 29 minutes played. 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Now Brown. Well, now they can attack, and he's got support with it. Here's Brown. James Collins. We've got to clear it now. The referee in control, because he's seen the advantage and indicated to the players to play on. Can put them in front here. Off the keeper. Back. He's hit the frame of the goal. Well, he's cleared the danger.
So close to taking the lead there, but the woodwork denying them. Just got to keep playing the way they are. Playing some good stuff at the moment. You can hear the roar going around this stadium. Anxious that their team can really capitalise on this really good spell.
No nonsense defending. It was needed. Some goal news for you from the Birmingham City game. Reporter Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Nottingham Forest. 39 minutes played. 2-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. So easy in possession. Maybe the cross. And that will be a throw. Well, he fancied his chance. He had the technique to get that on target, but it didn't work out.
Just wonder whether he took his eye off the ball at the last moment. Well, I do hope it's going to liven up here, Martin. Otherwise, I might just head off before the end of this one. Nothing really to talk about.
On the attack here. And that's a turnover to the opposition.
Fucking play, so fucking shit all of a sudden.
Now Brown. Now there is some space in the wide area.
The fourth official has indicated.
Here's Brown. He's cut that out well, well read. Here's Robinson. He can cross it now.
What?
And there is the half-time whistle. 0-0.
Fucking P9. Stand by it.
And they kick off at the start of the second half. On the move and able to cut out the pass. Certainly playing well enough to get their noses in front here. Let's join Alan McAnally now. News of a goal, I believe, in the Derby County match. Over to you, Alan.
It's a second goal for Stoke City. It's been scored by James McLean. That's his second today. He latched onto a ball behind the defence and slotted home. 49 minutes played. 2-0.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. Just take a note of this. EA Sports coverage of the EFL Championship fixture. West Bromwich Albion, they'll be facing Millwall.
Yeah, a lot of people have been talking about this one. Looking forward to it.
And that will end the threat, at least for the moment. Difficult for the defender against a player who wants to take him on like this. Corner given. And they'll be hoping to get this set piece right. The goal that will put them into the lead. Put the corner in the middle. Yates, Pearson. Just lost their way in the final moments of that attack. So many riches now for the Premier League clubs in England with the lucrative television deal, and Arsenal have spent some of their incoming money. It's outgoing on this player.
Yeah, it seemed the price was going up every week, and it's reached about 55 million. So the newspapers tell us.
I want to just freshen things up a bit here, West Brom, I think, with a substitution.
Still got a bit so
to do,
bad.
But this is promising. You can see what he was trying to do with the cross, but it's a goal kick. The manager's going to bring on a fresh player now. We've reached the hour mark. Half an hour to go. Livermore steered through. Great chance.
Thank you.
He is a saviour there. Yates, Potts. Going to be West Bromwich Albion to make the substitution. Well, this will be interesting. Changes now for both teams. Here's Brown. Well, this is where the space is at the moment on the flanks. A chance to play it into the centre now. He's given it away.
Not been the most entertaining, and it's been very even as the possession stats bear out. Will we get to see some
probing the pass? Wonderful chance! Oh, it's a great goal! It's a good performance from a very good team, a team that we expected to be better than the opposition. That's the way it's panning out so far.
Yeah, you'd expect them to ease away from the opposition in this match. Can't see any shocks in it, I can't really.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Substitution for Luton Town. Coming off the pitch, number 20, George Moncler. To be replaced by
now Brown.
Number 11, Andrew Shinney.
And 20 minutes to go. They can't keep it on the pitch, what? It's gone out for a throw.
To what?
Saw that coming and intercepted. His teammates have recognised the potential of this attack. Let's go over to Alan McAnally for news of the Birmingham City match. And Alan, I believe there's been a goal.
It's a third goal for Nottingham Forest. 73 minutes played, 3-0.
Thanks, Alan. Pearson. It's good attacking play, this, from them. Very good work from the team that's still behind, but one goal away, of course, from equalising. And the ball with West Bromwich Albion again. Filip Krovinovic. Good connection, just off target, over the top.
Yeah, that has flown off his foot.
Number 4, Ryan Tunnicliffe, to be replaced by number 16, Glenn Ray.
He's got possession back for his team. We have some goal news for you from the Hull City fixture, and it's from Alan McAnally.
It's a third goal for Brentford. 80 minutes played, 3-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Here's Phillips. Difficult for the defender against the player who wants to take him on like this. Looking to attack it in the middle. Really vital interception here. West Brom want to make a change. Livermore. That's super feet there from the player.
Those feet move so quickly.
And now a throw-in. Well, it's going to be a substitution now. Filip Krovinovic. And they've got a man out wide. Saved by the keeper. He can't hang on to the ball. Livermore. Aim for those in the middle. Headed back into the middle. Safety first there. He shielded it well.
good defending.
There will be a minimum of 2 minutes of added time.
Now Brown. Yates. Here's Brown. The final whistle. Probing the pass. Wonderful chance.
And welcome to a game that really should have pulses racing. Every reason to believe this will be enthralling. I'm Derek Ray, here on the commentary position, joined by Lee Dixon to help me describe all the action. And what we have for you is live action from the Championship. It's Millwall up against West Bromwich Albion.
Thank you, Derek. Just flicking through my notes at this one, everything pointing to a really lively matchup this is. Fingers crossed, eh?
Now the Millwall starting 11. It looks like a conventional 4-4-2.
A preferred formation by Arsene Wenger when he arrived at Arsenal. Two main strikers, four across the midfield. Really important for the fullbacks to link up with the wide midfielders in this system.
He read the cross, but now must clatter it clear. But almost an early test of officialdom. What's the referee going to do? So early in this game, and the referee not really hesitating. A yellow card it is, and that could make it difficult for player and official.
Well, it changes the complexion of your game, the way you play your match, especially if you're a defender. You start thinking about the challenges instead.
Surely, the crossbar got in the way. And it's played into the centre. Foiling them effectively. Furlong. It needs an accurate cross. An attack full of promise. And a very good challenge. And a throw-in it's going to be. It's been well nigh impossible to escape all the news stories surrounding him ahead of the game. And the rumours, it's a weighted pass. Aware of the threat, solving the problem. And the cross goes in. Keeper did his job to begin with. I believe there's been a goal in the Stoke City match. Alan McInerney can tell us more.
It's a goal for Stoke City. 13 minutes played. 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Sangare. Individual quality coming to the fore. Well, that's how to do it inside your own penalty area. Furlong and scope for the cross. Darnell Furlong. Livermore. Well, they're sitting ever deeper. Can't miss, surely! And he got to it fairly easily. Sangare. And here's Jake Livermore. He's in control of the situation. Townsend. Robinson. There's a slide rule pass! And it's come off the keeper. Doughty defending to win the ball back. Jon Daði Böðvarsson. Good numerical situation. Delivered into the area here. Absolutely nothing wrong with the idea, but no end product.
Oh my days.
Well, they had a decent reading of that ball in. And the counter looks on here. A real chance.
Oh no, if I can't wait to make it.
O'Brien.
Is that a broken wall?
Well, they've simply got to play better. They can't keep conceding chances in the back. They've dodged another one. The crowd are letting them know about it as well, urging them on to try and improve themselves.
Romeo. Well, just couldn't quite keep himself onside. Oh, the flag has gone up. Darnell Furlong. O'Brien. News coming through of a goal in the Leeds United match. Let's hear about it from Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Leeds United. 34 minutes, played. 1-0.
Regular updates from Alan McInally along the way.
The visitors have had total control of possession, but I don't think the manager or the fans will be too happy with this performance. It's all been a little bit too slow, too pedestrian. They need to find another gear if they're going to go on and win this.
He's protecting it effectively. Well, the pass not finding its target. And a chance for him on the flank. Space and time for the cross. Just unable to get his cross beyond the first defender. Quick thinking to dispossess his opponent. Is it going to end up being productive for them? Can they take the lead? The opening goal, due reward for their efforts.
Well, they've made the pressure count. They really deserve this lead. Well, when you come to a game, you want to see skill like this. It's absolutely brilliant dribbling. The defender, he's all over the place. What a goal.
The opening goal of the game then. We've had the official word, there will be a minimum of 2 added minutes. He's got space. Well, that's how to do it, inside your own penalty area. And the corner's been given. And he's fired over the corner. Won it back. And so it is, the first half story. The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. It's with Hutchinson. Hutchinson. Wallace. Wallace. Sean Hutchinson. They've given it away. And they will be awarded a free kick for that. That could well be his final warning. He's got to tread carefully from here on in.
Well, he has, yeah, but it's quite easy for the referees to throw yellow cards around willy-nilly, but not on this occasion.
Textbook defending inside the box. A goal has gone in at the Stoke City Stadium. Let's hear all about it from Alan.
It's a second goal for Stoke City. 51 minutes played. 2-0.
Alan McAnally keeping us right up to date. Playing with purpose and control. Really sitting deep now. That could be problematic. Can they get in behind them? Magnificent challenge to win it back. Well, the Championship is such a competitive division, and this is a game for you to look forward to on EA TV. It's Millwall facing Fulham.
Yeah, really looking forward to it. Always a great atmosphere in that stadium. Should be a really entertaining match.
Ryan Woods. Doughty defending to win the ball back.
What was that?
Just looking ahead to another game coming up. A really sumptuous ball into the advanced position. Delivering it into the box. But he just drifted into the illegal position. Offside, in the opinion of the officials. Substitution time it is. It's with Kyle Barkley. What a big breaking transfer story, and very happy to be able to share the news. Jonathan Tah has completed his move to Athletic Bilbao.
Well, Derek, a figure of around £35 million is being bandied around. I'd say you get a lot of player for that sort of money. He should be a real asset to the club.
Wallace. And here's Jake Livermore. Livermore. Krovinovic. Plenty of forward momentum here, but can they produce? Bradshaw. Jón-Daði Böðvarsson. O'Brien. Not a good pass. Beautifully weighted ball. Dangerous looking attack. Fruitful looking attack. Not really close to worrying the scoreboard operator.
No, it's worth a try though, but when he...